right direction, put the right direction, and everything's back together. So now that we've done that, we're going to go back over and insert our stem. Insert to the valve stem, and then we can put air in it. So I'm going to go back over to the workbench. I'm going to pick up the tube, and then, like I said, be careful with this part. It's just the reason I say it is because it's so small. Insert it there, and then put this in. Now, the valve stem remover tool, I'm just using one that is a valve cap style. This particular item, you can see the end. You can get it in any bike shop. It's really inexpensive, just a couple bucks. And like I said, the tools, but this allows you to do the work on not only your Firefly front tires, but on your wheelchair tires without pinching the tube, scratching up the rim, which leaves really sharp edges that will also punch your tube while you're trying to do repairs. So it's best that if you're going to do your own work, make sure you invest a little bit on those pieces. Now that the stem's in there, I'm going to inflate the tire. I do have a compressor. I'm not sure what. If you happen to have a chance, I picked up this compressor up here in Portland, where I'm from, Oregon. Harbor Tool and Freight. I'm not sure if they're nationwide, but if they are, I think I paid $99 for this 2.5 gallon, 125 psi. Compressor, well worth it because of your bike. Most of us that have wheelchairs, those tires can be anywhere from 100 to 145 psi. Though I know this only goes to 125, I'm comfortable with my tires at that temperature or tire pressure. So I went with it, and it was, like I said, not all that expensive. So now, when you inflate the tire, you only want to put in a little air at a time, just to get it set up, because you want to make sure that you seat the tire around the rim. So as you see, there's a, you can see it, you'll see a little line in there. You want to make sure that this is all seated around there and it's not trying to pop out. Once you see that you've got a good seat on it, you can fill it up the rest of the way. Now, the tire recommendation for this, if you can see it, it's 40 psi, and so on this inflator, I actually can see the pressure gauge as I look at it, see that I'm at 40 psi. So now release that, we'll set that down. We're going to put the plastic cap back on the end of the valve stem. And so, you know, the reason that, there's a couple reasons you put the plastic cap on. One is to protect the and also the valve stem inside itself. Another reason is sometimes, just every so often, that may leak. That there is a little rubber gasket on that stem insert, and then if it ever had a problem, it and leaked. The cap actually does work at holding the air back in that in cases where it's happened like that. It's not all that often, actually. It's fairly rare. So now that you can see the tire, it's been replaced, and I have it all in the right direction. So now I'm going to reassemble the front end of my Firefly. And so we're going to go back to the tools that I have. So you'll need your 17 millimeter. I have two just so that I can get leverage when I put it back on, but it's not necessary. You can just do it with one. Now, the trick to putting it back on the Firefly's forks is, I'm going to show you right here. If you look right here, you'll see that this is an actual crown slot. So this actually slides in there, and this is the bottom of it. So when you slide this in to the front end, you need to have it in the right direction, as you can see here, so that it only slides so far. The other thing you want to look at is your rotors. The rotor to the brakes, all right, because they have to slide into that same small area that you took it out of. And so just give it a little nudge if it needs to get this in the right direction, and you'll see what I mean when I get it going. that up. Yeah. And so you really want to. So see how it slides in? So now you'll see, I don't know if you can see it that clearly, but that piece only allow, it can only go on one way with this piece sliding in. Now that it's in there straight. Make sure that both sides are evenly pushed back. If you don't, and try to get ahead of yourself, or you're not sure, what'll happen is this rotor will rub your brakes, and it'll actually wear this rotor out. Rotors are around $30 to $40, and up. You can get a lot nicer. Now, on my Firefly, you'll see that I have replaced the actual calipers for Avid 5 BB5s, a lot nicer. Nicer cable systems. They're so much easier to move about. They don't bind whatsoever. Now these are flex. You can go with a non-flex tile. If you want to go to a bike shop, they'll replace it. It takes them just a few minutes. And that non-flex will allow the no movement of the cable, and so you won't ever have that weird feeling of the brakes not always there. And part of that is that flex feeling. So now that I've got this on the way back, I finger tight, and now I'm going to tighten this up, and you're just going to hand tighten that down as hard as you can, and I'm going to do the same on this side, and then we're going to just check our tightness here on this side one more time, and then one more back just to verify that everything's tight. And now as you can see, the tire is back, and it's in the right direction. Alright, so now that we've assembled that part of the tire and put it all back together, we now need to put the wiring back together. So we're going to slide the plastic protector cap to the end of the rotor motor or hub motor, and that will go on just like so until it's snug. And then what we're going to do is on the side here, we're going to come back around and we're going to hook up the motor to the control panel and throttle. So remember, as I had mentioned earlier, you want to look for those arrows. Probably should do some, take some white out or something and put it on there or something. So you want to look for the arrow. I have one there and I have one there. And you want to line those up. And that's how they go together. And it'll kind of snap into place. And that's how you put it.